Namaste children, welcome to today's English class. What do you look here children? What is the picture? Yes, it is a book. Now, describe this book. How do you describe this book children? When you look at the book, you will be able to describe it. How do you describe it? By its shape. So how is it? Whether it is rectangle or square shape, that you will describe. And you will say that the book is very huge one, and how it is soft or rough, you have to say. Then you will also tell the color of the book, isn't it? So now we describe the book by the different things. Okay, anything we describe it by its shape, color, size and texture. Shape is rectangle or square. Color is red, yellow, blue, like that. Size is whether it is huge or small. Texture is rough or smooth. Okay, children. Now, in today's class, we are going to read Block 15 Exceed English of Class 4, The Fly, which is written by Walter D. La Mer. In this particular video, I am going to teach you how to write similes and also how to use these similes in a descriptive writing. And when you use similes in a descriptive writing, the writing becomes very excellent and also interesting. And at the end of this particular video, you will be able to write similes by comparing two things with a common feature. And also, you will be able to write a descriptive paragraph using similes. Now, let us read the poem. And in this poem, we have similes also, isn't it? In our previous video, we have done it. And in today's class, we'll read or we will learn how to write the similes in detail. How large unto the tiny fly must little things appear? A rosebud like a feather bed, its prickle like a spear, a dewdrop like a looking glass, a hair like golden wire, the smallest grain of mustard seed, as fierce as coal of fire, a loaf of bread, a lofty hill, as a wasp, a creole leopard, and specks of salt as bright to see, as lambkins to a shepherd. Okay, now look at this particular picture, children. What is this? Yes, it is knife. Your mother uses to cut vegetables, isn't it, children? Yes. Now, describe this knife. Can you describe this? Yes, the knife is very sharp. So, sharp is an adjective to describe this knife. So, this is one thing which we are taking, children. Now, you tell me one more thing which has the same adjective sharp, or to that particular thing also sharp should be there, or adjective sharp should be used. Think of another thing, children. Yes. So another thing. So this is one thing which we have taken, that is knife. Another thing also should have same adjective, that is sharp. Yes. Very good. You can see this one. What is this, children? Yes. Broken glass. So broken glass, it is very sharp. So knife is sharp and broken glass also is sharp. Now, what are the two things which we have taken, children? First one is knife. After taking that knife, then what is the adjective which we have given to that knife? Yes, very good. Sharp adjective we have given. And we thought of another thing which should have the same adjective. So what is the other thing which we have taken? Yes, very good. Broken glass. So what is common in these two things? The common is sharpness, that is sharp. So now we have to write a simile. Okay, so how to write a simile? So here two objects we have taken. So what are the two objects? Knife and broken glass. So we have to use like or as in order to write a simile. So can we put like this, children? Did you guess it? Yes, very good. The knife is sharp like a broken glass, isn't it? The knife is sharp like a broken glass. And and the other one, the knife is as sharp as a broken glass. Yes, you can see here, children, the knife is sharp like a broken glass. The knife is as sharp as a broken glass. Clear, children? Now, let us see some more examples. Now, here, simile. So, what is the simile? A comparison between two things using as or like. So, two things we have to compare using like and as. Like or as, anyone. So, here are the two things. So, here in the picture, in the circle, here it is. Here, we have two things. So, what is the first one, children? Girl. The second one is son. Now, when we take the two things, we need to describe them. We have to sort out the adjectives. So, for the girl, she has blue eyes. Blend. Blend refers to brown hair, children. And smile, bright smile. Now, coming to sun. The sun is round, yellow, bright. Now, tell me, what is the common adjective which is used for these two? Yes, the common adjective is bright. So, now we need to use this feature, that is the bright, the common adjective, and write a simile. So, how we will write? Her smile is as bright as the sun. Okay, her smile is bright like the sun. So, two ways. So, her smile is as bright as the sun. Her smile is bright like the sun. Is this clear, children? Now, what are the different steps which we have used to write this particular simile? So, first, what did we do, children? We have to think of a thing. Then, that particular thing, we have described it with an adjective, isn't it? So, what is the thing which we have taken first, children? Yes, very good. Knife. Then we have described that knife with one adjective. What is that adjective? Very good. Sharp. Now, so two steps over. Third step, what did we do, children? Yes. Think of another thing that can be described by adjective. So, we thought of another thing. So, another thing also should have the same adjective, that is sharp. So, what is the other thing which we have taken? Very good. Broken glass we have taken. Okay. Now, finally, we have to write the simile using like and as. Is this clear, children, how to write a simile? Now, we'll see some examples. Okay. Today, I'm feeling as fresh as a daisy. So, now, children, coming to this similes, we can write similes between things, persons, places, and also feelings also. Okay. So, here some examples are there. Let us look at it. Today, I am feeling as fresh as a daisy. John runs as fast as lightning. Okay. My best friend is as stubborn as a mule. So, here best friend and mule. These are the two things. And what is the common feature for these two things? Stubborn. Okay. Doesn't listen anything. Very stubborn. Okay. So, John runs as fast as lightning. So, John and lightning, both are the things. So, John is a person and lightning. So, both are things. So, what is the common feature which we have used here? Fast. So, both of them are very fast. Okay. So, John runs as fast as lightning. So, how lightning comes in the sky and goes off like that, so fast this John runs. Okay. After that meal, I feel as fat as a pig. Okay. My little sister works as slow as a turtle. So, here two things are there. What are that? Sister and turtle. Okay. We are comparing. So, what is the feature both for both of them? What is the same? What is the adjective? That is slow. So, both are slow. Okay. So, my sister works as slow as a turtle. Without my glasses, I am as blind as a bat. That boy in my class is as funny as a clown. Clown is a joker. Right now, I am feeling as sick as a dog. Have you ever felt as happy as a hippo? When she kissed me, I turned as red as a tomato. Clear, children? Now, let us see the workbook exercises, children. Okay, now open your workbook to page number 37. Okay, Now, underline the similes in the lines from the poem Flint. So, Flint is the name of the poem, children, and you need to underline the similes here. An emerald is as green as grass. A ruby red as blood. A sapphire shines as blue as heaven. A flint lies in the mud. Okay, so here you need to underline the similes. I think you can do it, children. It is very easy. As green as. Okay, clear? A ruby red as blue as. So these similes you have to underline. Now coming to the second bit, children. Fill in the table for the lines in the above poem. So based on that particular poem, you have to fill this one. So first one, what is compared? An emerald is as green as grass. So what we are comparing here, children? Emerald. Emerald is a stone. Okay, that stone is green in color. And with what it is compared to? So here, an emerald is as green as grass. So what is compared here? Emerald is compared to what? Grass. What is the quality of emerald and grass? Green. Got it, children? So emerald is a stone which is green in color. Okay, so we are comparing that emerald, that particular stone, with what we are comparing? It is as green as grass. With grass we are comparing, because grass also is green in color. So first we are comparing, what is compared here? Emerald is compared, it is compared to a grass. And what quality is compared? What is same in both emerald and grass? Very good, green. Okay, so in the first one you will write emerald, then grass, then green. Okay, children. Now the next one, a ruby red as blood. Okay, so what is compared here in the second line? Ruby. Okay, so what it is compared to? Ruby. Ruby is red in color, children. Okay, ruby we are comparing. Ruby we are comparing to what? Blood. Okay, so blood also red in color. Then what is the same quality in ruby and blood? Very good. Same thing is red in color. Both are red in color. So in the first column you will write ruby. Second column, to what it is compared? To blood it is compared. And in both of them, what is the common feature or the quality? Red. Very good. Now the next line, children. A sapphire shines as blue as heaven. So what is compared here? Very good, sapphire. It is compared to what? Heaven. Very good. And what is same in, what is the common feature or what quality is compared here? Yes, blue color. Blue. Okay. Is this clear, children? Second bit. Now we'll move on to the third one. Use the given adjectives to write similes. So here adjectives are given for us. We needn't think of any adjectives. Adjectives are given and now we need to write a sentence. Now the first one is done for us, children. So now I'll read out the adjectives. Free, fast, busy, brave, playful, strong, warm. Okay. Now first one. I feel free like a bird. Okay. So here free is there. Okay, I feel free like a bird. Now next, fast. So how do you write this fast? Someone runs. We will take it that only. Indu runs as fast as cheetah. Okay, so we have to take what is compared to. Okay, what it is. What is compared and to what it is compared and the quality. So quality is given here, children. We have to write both the things, starting and the last one. Clear? Now, fast, how did we write, children? Indu runs as fast as cheetah. Now, next one is busy. Who is very busy, children? Yes, your mother is very busy, isn't it? My mother is as busy as a bee. Okay, my mother is as busy as a bee. Now, next one is brave. So, who brave? Whom do you think is very brave, children, for the country? Yes, very good. Soldiers, they are very brave, isn't it? The soldiers are brave like a lion. Okay, the soldiers are brave like a lion. Next one is playful. My brother is as playful as my friend. Okay, strong. Who is very strong? Yes. Are you strong? Yes, I'm as strong as an ox. So you are comparing yourself to the ox. Okay, so what is the feature? Same feature, strong. Okay, now next one is warm. A sweater is as warm as a fire. Okay, now next one, write a simile to describe an excellent swimmer. Okay, one simile you have to use. Okay, write a simile to describe an excellent swimmer. So my brother swims like a fish. My brother swims like a fish. Is this clear, children? Now shall we move on to the next one? That is S for yes. Very good. Now coming to S for, that is descriptive writing. It is in page number 37. Okay, children. Now I'll read out this. Here we need to, first one, children, underline the adjectives and circle the nouns in the paragraph. So now see this S4 descriptive writing. First one, underline the adjectives and circle the nouns in the paragraph. I'll read out the passage, children, this particular paragraph. You have to underline the adjectives and you have to circle the nouns. Then we will write, we'll make this paragraph more interesting by using some similes, and finally we will give one title to it, children. Okay. Now see here, our science teacher gave us a project to gather information on different plants and trees. So I'll read one sentence and then we'll discuss. Okay. So our science teacher gave us a project to gather information on different plants and trees. So here, what is noun, children, here? Very good. Teacher is a noun. Then project is a noun. Okay, you can circle. Plants is a noun and trees also is a noun. So you can circle teacher, project, plants, trees. Now different plants is there, children. So what is different? It is describing, no, describing the plants. So underline different. So different is an adjective. So in this sentence, what did we circle, children? Teacher, project, plants, trees. And we have underlined different. Very good. Now the second sentence. My friend and I went to my uncle's farm. So your friend is a noun. Okay. And I is a pronoun. Okay. It is a pronoun. No need that one. Uncle's farm. So uncle also you can circle. Uncle is a noun. And farm also noun. So we have circled friend, uncle, farm. Very good. He loves gardening and lives on a huge farm on the outskirts of the town. So what we have to underline here? Farm. Already we have underlined, circled a farm. Again we will circle, children. Farm is in a farm. And huge farm. So farm is described very huge. Okay. So very big. So that huge is an adjective. Very good. Underline huge and circle the farm. Okay. Town also you can circle. Town is a noun. He took us through the dense forest beside the farm. So he took beside the farm. So dense forest. Okay. Dense means so many trees are there. Thick forest. So forest is a noun and farm also noun. Dense, describing the forest, how the forest is. So dense is an adjective. So that you can underline. We saw many different types of leaves. Okay. So leaves. Okay. And types. Both are nouns. And again different is an adjective, children. Now next one. Some of them were very big. Okay. Big. So what is big? So we are describing some of these leaves are very big, isn't it? So that big is an adjective. One of them even looked like an elephant's ear to me. So here, elephant's ear is a noun. Okay, it is a noun, children. Is a noun. And there were others that were very small. So some were very small. So some other thing, and leaves are very small. So small is an adjective. You can underline. Even an ant would think them too small for a bed. So ant is a noun. Okay, small is an adjective. It is an adjective. We saw different colored flowers. okay, different again it is an adjective, underline it. Colored also adjective, flowers is a noun, okay, and in full bloom, so full is an adjective, you can underline it. Bloom is a noun, okay. They were blue, pink, yellow and orange ones. So all the colors are adjective, children. Okay, all the colors are adjective. So underline blue, pink, yellow, orange. Okay. If my uncle would have let me, I would have made a rainbow with these flowers. So your uncle is a noun. Okay. And rainbow also is a noun. Flowers also noun. Okay. Thank you, ma'am, for giving us such an interesting project. We had great fun doing it. So here project is a noun. And here the project is described, children. Interesting project. So interesting is a, it is an adjective. So we had great fun doing it. Is this clear, children? So we have circled all the nouns and we have underlined the adjectives. Now, make this paragraph more descriptive by rewriting it with similes that describe at least three of the nouns that you circled. Now we will take some nouns. One sentence from the passage from this paragraph we will take, children, and we will add a simile to it. Okay. So here the farm is, you can see here, it is very huge. Somewhere it is given, no, adjective. The farm is very huge. It is given, no, children. Where it is? Yes, here. My friend and I went to my uncle's farm. Okay. He loves gardening and lives on a huge farm on the outskirts, no? So, huge farm. So, whose farm? Okay. We can say the farm. So, the farm is as huge as a, anything you can write. Okay. So, huge is an adjective which is described. So farm is one thing. So the farm is as huge as a, can we write stadium, children? Stadium also is very huge, no? So we'll compare it with a stadium. Okay, so the farm is as huge as a stadium. Is this clear, children? Have you all understood? Now we will take one more adjective. Okay. The leaves, something it is given about the leaves. Some leaves, it is one of them even looked like an elephant's ear to me. So one of them is one leaf, no, some leaves. So some leaves were as big as an elephant's ear. Okay, so some leaves were as big as an elephant's ear. Now next one, coming to the last one, children, something about I would have made a rainbow with these flowers. It is given, I would have made. So the colorful flowers, okay, colored flowers, they bloomed. So the flowers are very, are colored, the flowers are very colorful, no? So we will write about that colorful flowers to the rainbow, children. That we will make a simile. So how shall we write? Yes, the colorful flowers looked like a rainbow on the ground. So when the flowers bloom, all those flowers are very colorful and they look like a rainbow. So how we will add the simile here? Like we will use here, the colorful flowers looked like a rainbow on the ground. So now, is this clear, children? So here we have used three similes. Okay, three we have written it. Enough, children. Now we'll move on to the next one, third one. Give a title to your paragraph. So what title can we give? Very good. An interesting project, okay, or an amazing project, anything you can write. Is this clear, children? Have you all understood? Yes. Thank you, children.